broken their commitment to the RFS, and the result is farm income is below the cost of production. With commodity prices below the cost of production, farmers are facing some big, difficult challenges today. As governor, I know, because I was governor during the farm crisis in the 80s, and I don't want to see those bad times that come to our state again. As an ag state, we must unify and elect leaders that will not shy away from the tough decisions, that will not cave into the bureaucrats in Washington, D.C. We must end the overreach of the federal government by sending a message in November that our farmers feed and fuel the world, and we will not turn our backs on them. As my dad says, America needs farmers, and we must elect Donald Trump as our president to defend and support our farmers. Donald Trump is a man of character, a man who's not afraid to speak his mind, a man who will keep our nation safe, and a man who supports agriculture and the working people in the heartland of this great country. He's going to make America great again. Please join me in welcoming our next president of the United States.
Dedicated public servants in the country, including Governor Fairgrounds.
Amazing veterans, a lot of
yeah.
them.
November, and we are going to win the White House for the American people. The White House will soon become the people's house. That's what it's going to be. We will tackle and fix the problems that have gone unsolved for many, many years. Failing schools, crumbling infrastructure, broken borders, bloated bureaucracy, wasteful spending, and a government that doesn't work. Doesn't work. This is a campaign about big ideas designed to help everyday people, everyone, going to help everyone. These are the people who work hard, but who don't have a voice. Their voice has been taken away. It's also a campaign about restoring honesty and accountability to government. And you see what I'm just doing. The whole world has been shocked by the continuing revelations regarding Hillary Clinton and her pay-for-play State Department and other things. Now it was just announced that her important calendar records will not be released, because they have, to the public until after the election, because there's too much stuff on that. They want it after the election. It's only terrible. It's terrible. It's protection from a corrupt, rigged system. It's disgusting. As I've said many times in recent days, it's hard to tell where the Clinton Foundation ends and where the State Department begins. That's what's happened. The Clinton corruption scandals have been really there for a long time, and it's been sad, sad, sad for America. The illegal server, the foreign hacking, the deleted emails of 33,000. The deleted emails, 33,000. The secret schedules, the lying to Congress. It's all just too much. We're going to have a great victory on November 8th, I can tell you. Even if she thinks that, she's got bad judgment. She thinks she's above the law. So far, she's proven that. But the truth is, it's the opposite. Her criminal conduct at home and her failed interventions overseas simply make her unfit. She is unfit to serve in the Oval Office. I believe that America is ready to turn the page on this very sordid past. We don't want another 4 years of Obama or Clinton controversy. They're not only dangerous, but frankly, they're exhausting our people. How do you even keep up with it all? How do you do it? The Clintons have had their time on the stage, but now it's time to close that chapter in the history book and open a brand new, beautiful chapter. Thank you very much. That is why this is such an exciting year to be a Republican and to vote Republican. We're going to do a great job. This year, the GOP is offering the voters a chance to break up the corrupt establishment and create a new American future. Yeah. In my opinion, this is our last chance. I really believe that. This chance will never come again. And remember, justices of the Supreme Court. Remember that. This chair, it will never, ever come again. It will never happen again. I really believe you're not going to have this opportunity again. The big banks and Wall Street donors who want nothing to change are throwing millions and millions of dollars at my opponent. These are the same people who paid Bill and Hillary Clinton $150 million for speeches and I guess some other things. Hillary Clinton's campaign is all about protecting the powerful. And I understand that very well. I think nobody knows the system better than I do. Our campaign is about protecting those who have no power. They don't have power, but they're great, great people. They are great people without power. We're going to change that. They'll be great power. They will be great people with power. Together, we're going to work. We're going to give working people a voice for the first time in many, many decades. They haven't had a voice in a long time. Let's talk about what it all means. For our veterans, it means a guarantee that they can seek medical care at either a VA facility or at a private medical doctor with us paying the cost. Thank you, because you've had such incredible veteran support. Uniform all across the land. Never again will we allow a veteran to die waiting for the care they need from a doctor, from a fine doctor, but you can't get to ever see your doctor. You wait 6 days, 7 days, 9 days. Woo! People who die on the line, but it's not going to happen. We will protect those who protect us. These are our great people. Yeah. We are going to protect them. It's our turn now. At the center of our change, and this is a change agenda, is also a plan to fix our rigged economy. It's rigged. The government just revised the growth numbers. You probably saw yesterday, it was a big story. We had horrible growth numbers. They were announced last month. They made a mistake. They just announced that the number that was announced that was so bad was too high and it had to be readjusted downward, down to 1.1%. Just so you understand, if China jobs down to 8% GDP or 9% GDP, it's a major catastrophe, and the same with other countries. And they do things that you don't want to know about, but they make it impossible for your businesses to compete. But they consider it a catastrophe. Here we are with no growth, 1.1%, which is no growth. And we have the same leaders that are incompetent and don't know what they're doing, but we're going to make a change.
Grow again, grow. That begins with supporting our family farms right here in Iowa. Do we have any farmers in the room? Do we have any? Stand up. Stand up. That's a lot of farmers. That's a lot of farmers. Wow. Beautiful. That's a lot of farmers. Great farmers. One of the most beautiful landscapes in the world, especially if you like farms, right? Family farms are the backbone of this country, remember that.
Yeah!
And I know what's happening to you. We are going to end the EPA intrusion into your family homes and into your family farms. For no reason. What they're doing to you is a disgrace. We're going to get rid of a lot of those regulations that don't mean anything except cost you a lot of money and a lot of time, and in many cases, you lose your farms under the regulations. We are going to reduce taxes from 35% to 15%. And the thing that most surprised me is in going around all over the country and talking about that massive tax cut, and also for the middle class, but the massive small business and business tax cut, or the reduction by a lot of regulations, 100% of the people I talk to feel more strongly about the regulations. And who would have thought about that? Who would have thought that could happen?
but they feel more strongly about getting rid of these horrible, really horrible regulations, and that's what we're going to do. We are going to protect the renewable fuel standard. Corn-based ethanol, eliminate job-killing regulations like the Waters of the United States rule, which is a disaster,
yep,
and provide desperately needed tax relief. President Obama lied to you about his support for the renewable fuel standard, and you can trust Hillary Clinton far less than you could even Obama. She will sell you out. She's already sold you out, and her donors will be the only ones that are happy.
That's right.
And you see it happen, just like Obama. He made lots of promises, and then he said bye-bye to Iowa, bye-bye, and to other places. Almost 97% of farms in this country are family-owned and family-managed. It's not only a great American tradition, but a vital component of America's economic and national security. So true. Yet Hillary Clinton wants to shut down family farms just like she wants to shut down the miners and the steel workers. She's going to shut them down. That I can tell you. She will do this not only through radical regulation, but also by raising taxes on family farms to rates as high as, and I think actually higher than 50%. And just so you understand, I'm cutting taxes massively. She is raising taxes massively. Adding to the pain, she will tax family farms again at death by as much as 45%. And you've already paid your tax, right? You've paid your tax. Now you're going to pay it again, and your children and family, it's a very tough situation, you know that. On top of that, her anti-energy agenda will drive up the cost of energy, another attack on agriculture. It's a big attack on what you're doing because you need the energy. We're going to end this war on the American farmer. You are going to like Donald Trump so much.
Yeah!
That includes our plan to lower the tax rate on family farms down to 15% and to stop double taxation on the family farms at death, helping to ensure that the family farm tradition in Iowa continues to thrive and flourish with your children and your grandchildren, and you'll be looking down and you'll be happy. We hope you're looking down. We hope you're looking down. You'll be very happy and very proud. We're going to make a very powerful and great trade deal. We're going to have fantastic...